Well, it is a great pleasure for me to recognize a number of alumni from the college. Our first distinguished alum today is Judge Raymond Uno.
Thank you very much for the kind introduction. I have always considered myself a foot soldier fighting in the trenches. That is where the real action is, and you are faced with baptism under fire. It has always been a learning experience. I've had to recalibrate my life often to adjust to the rapid changes and conditions, like most of you have. I've learned from the mistakes of others. Trust me, you can't live long enough to make all them yourselves. I have tried. I still don't know how I got over the hill without getting to the top, but I know what I learned at the U has helped me an awful lot. In closing, I think I'd like to remember J.D. Williams. He was fresh out of Harvard and one of my most favorite and first professors. He demonstrated to me the following: be kinder than necessary, for everyone you meet is fighting some kind of battle. Sometimes being kind is more important than being right. Love generously, care deeply, and speak kindly. Life is too short for regrets. It is not what you gather, but what you scatter that tells what kind of life you live.
Our next honoree today is Clark Ivory.
I wanted to say that I feel lucky. I loved coming to the university, and probably I loved it because I was in the College of Social and Behavioral Science. I loved what I studied. And I think the only reason that I was able to go on and go to Harvard was because I studied what I liked. I did better at what I liked, and it was just fun to go to school every day. And I can remember studying the Federalist Papers with then Governor Scott Matheson and Professor Bob Huffner. We would go either to the office of the governor, or we'd go to the governor's mansion, and we would debate the Federalist Papers and what was applicable in today's world. And it was just fascinating. And he didn't mind, the governor nor Bob didn't mind having the students disagree and engage, and it was just absolutely invigorating. I remember having a comparative science class with John Francis that was equally motivating and just got me excited about looking at the entire world. And of course, the Hinckley Institute, where I did two internships, was enriching to the whole process. And I'm grateful for what the College of Social and Behavioral Science has taught me. The one thing it has not taught me, and I never quite figured out the behavioral side of this college. So perhaps in the next 20 years, that's what I'll work on. But I'm very grateful. Thank you very much, Dean. Right.
Our next honoree today is Barbara Vance.
The real reason I'm here is because of the experience I've had since the year 2000, when I joined the advisory board of the Family and Consumer Studies Department. And 3 years later, I served on the college board. And at first I was very timid when I came on the board, timid, but I was. And I received a welcome that it just was unequaled. And I realized that I was with a group of people who, number one, didn't have egos to be massaged. And number two, they were getting the same salary I was. And actually, the salary I was getting was much better than money ever could have been. And I just want you to know that I am a Utah woman, sure. And I will be till I'm dead.
Our final honoree this afternoon is Irv Altman. And Irv is being honored as an honorary distinguished alum.
I want to say a word about this college, because even though you are all supporters, I think you need to understand that this college is a very distinct unit on this campus. We are not the wealthiest college, but we produce more degrees than any other college on this campus. If you read this morning's paper, you will see that the College of Social and Behavioral Science departments, four of the departments are among the top 10 in the university awarding degrees. Economics, psychology, family and consumer studies, and sociology. We offer more degrees, we do more teaching than any other college, and that's pretty distinctive. In addition, in the sense that we are the college that really focuses on an incredible array of topics, all the way from brain functioning to individual behavior to human development to consumer studies to culture, archaeology, political science, economics of all stripes, we really cover a tremendous gamut, which makes it pretty tough for a dean to keep these people unified because they're all in different directions. But the really unique quality of this college is that we study contemporary issues. We are the commentators on contemporary issues, and sometimes those topics are pretty touchy and pretty sensitive to communities. But we are the ones who address those issues more than any other college, and that's pretty distinctive.